Hello everyone and welcome back. So I would like to begin this video with an apology for keeping you guys waiting. Actually, I was putting one or two things in place, and now that I'm back, I promise to give you guys back-to-back videos. So the agenda for today we are going to look at how we can implement Expo notification in our React Native application. So for this and more, let's dive into it. Alright, so we are going to cover two phases, okay? The first phase has to do with what happens at the server side, and then the second phase we are going to look at what happens at the mobile side, which is our React Native application side. So without wasting much time, let's dive into it. So I have two folders here. The first one is the mobile, and then the second one is the server, okay? In the server, it's just a basic setup. We have our node models, gitignore, our app.js, package lock.json, and then our package.json. Okay, when we take a look at our package.json, we already have three dependencies here: course, Expo SDK or Expo Server SDK, and then Express. Okay, so the main guy is going to be Expo Server SDK. Okay, now when we take a look at the app.js, we are doing some importing here, and then we are defining our Express application. We are defining our ports. We are initializing our Expo, okay, and then we define some middleware here to kind of help us get body from our request. And then we have some routes here. The first one is just for testing, okay. And then this is where the actual implementation or actual focus should be, okay. So you have a post method, and then you have this route. In here we are grabbing some information from our request body, okay, token, title, body, and then metadata. Here we are validating the token to make sure it's an Expo token. You get my point? And then in here we are trying to structure the message data or the format of the message that we want to send, okay. So it includes token, which is the two. We have sound, title, body, and then metadata. All right now once we are done, we use Expo, the object that we created, right? We call it here, and then we have a method which is send push notification async, right? So this method basically send messages to their respective recipients, and you could see it takes in an array of messages, right? But because we are sending a message, we would have to kind of create this or bring this bracket, pass in the object, and then close it. So this one basically tells the function that it's an array, but it contains only one item, okay. And then once we are done, it returns an array of tickets, but we are not much interested in the tickets. What we are interested in is trying to push the notification or push the message. That's all. So that is what happens in the server or at the server side. Now let's quickly go to the mobile, which is the core of this video. Now I've already set up the React Native application, okay. If you don't know how to set it up, I have a video covering that. You can just go to my YouTube channel and then look out for React Native project setup, okay. I will also leave the link down below so you can feel free and check it out if you don't know how to set it up, okay. Once you are done, you can go back to app.tsx, okay. So this is the entry point of the application. And then here you could see we have a push notification manager, which basically serves as a wrapper around the entire application, okay. So let's dive into it. That is where the actual thing is happening. So we have a couple of things or dependencies that we will need to install before we can kickstart. Let's quickly go through the JSON. So we have Expo status bar, React, and then React Native. So these ones are defaults that would come once you set up the application, okay. And then the next one is Expo constant, Expo device, and Expo notification. So these are the three things that would need to install, right? So you can just type in, you can just open your terminal. Once your terminal is open, you can navigate to the root directory. So in my case, I will cd into mobile, right? And I'm going to type npm i, and I'm going to install all these packages. So Expo constant, right? And then Expo device, and then the last one will be Expo notification. So you would have to install all of them, right? Once you are done, so basically you're going to do this. Let me go back here, and then you press enter. I've already installed them, so I'm not going to do that.
Yeah.
So once you are done installing them, I think we are good to go. All right, so let's go back to our wrapper. Okay. All right, so let me quickly explain what these three imports we are going to use them for, okay? The first one, which is export device, we are going to use that to determine the device that we are actually running the application on, okay? And then we have export notification, which is the main guy. We are going to use that to kind of receive notifications, basically. And then we have the constant, which is the export constant. We are going to use that to grab some information from our app.json. Okay, now after that, we've done some setup here. We've called the notification, and then we've basically set some parameters here. So we have show alert. So when we receive a notification, do you want to show an alert? If yes, we set it to true. Okay, should play a sound. Should we add some sound to notifications? If yes, then you just set it to true. Should we show a badge? So most applications have this kind of feature where on the icon you get to see the number of notifications that the application has received, right? Yeah, basically that is what this one is also for. So these are the setup that we have implemented here. Now when you check the main wrapper, of course we are using TypeScript, so we're going to do a couple of type stuffs here, but I'm not really interested in that. Now when you get into it, we have this main function which is called register for push notification async. It's a promise function, okay? And then in here we have use effect. So the use effect is basically supposed to run once, and then we try to register our application that hey, we are ready for notifications, okay? So that is basically what this is for. So once we are done there, we can actually what you are doing here is we are actually creating a notification listener, okay? So here we call the notification add notification receive listener. So here whenever we receive any notification, we can log the information here, right? So this one, let me just leave it this way, okay? Good. And then when you come down here, we also have notification tap listener. So what happens when you tap on the notification that you've received on your device, right? Whatever you want to do after the tapping, you can implement that or start the implementation from this end, okay? Yeah, so let me dive deeper into how we register our application for notifications, okay? So the first thing we do here is we set a variable here, which is token, right? And then in here, if it's an Android device, you will need extra settings, okay? So what you have to do is you have to set expo notification, set channel async, okay? You pass in default here, we give it a name, importance, and I mean, just copy this and paste it here. You don't need to bother yourself much with it, okay? Now the next thing is we have to make sure we are running on a physical device, okay? Since no expo notification doesn't work on emulators or simulators, all right? So what we do here is we call device.isDevice just to know. So when you hover over this, you will clearly see some description: true if app is running on a real device, and false if app is running on a simulator or emulator, okay? So basically we are trying to make sure the application is running on a physical device in order to receive notifications and also do whatever we want to do with the notifications. Now after that, what we have to do is we have to first check whether the user has permitted the application to send notifications or receive notifications. We don't want to bother our users by broadcasting or sending notifications whilst they've not approved that, right? Yeah, so what we basically do here is we try to get permission, right? So here we check if we already have an existing status, and if it's not equal to granted, we go ahead and then request for permission. If the existing status is granted, then we bypass this check and then we move on to the next one, right? Now down here, what we are basically doing here is we are using the expo constants that we installed to grab the project ID from our EAS, okay? I'm going to talk about that in a second. We are going to look at how we can generate our project ID, okay? Now, after we've gotten the project ID, make sure we've gotten it right. After we've gotten it, we can now pass in the project ID to our expo or get expo push token async, okay? So this function is basically going to use the project ID and then some information about our physical device to generate a token for us. So this token will be user specific, so it's going to be for that particular device. And then once we get this token, we can use this token at the server side. Remember, during our server walkthrough, I made mention of some token here, right? Yeah, basically that is the token that we are going to get here. So once we get this token, we can use that to send notification to our physical device, basically. So that is I think what is happening in this application. Once we get that, we try and wrap that around this. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to run both the server and then the client applications, okay, and then we proceed. Right, so whilst our Metro Bundler is setting up, I would like us to also go through how we can get the project ID. Okay, so when you check your, let me close this one. When you check your app.json and then you scroll down here, clearly we could see we don't have any information which has to do with our project ID. Okay, we will have to generate one ourselves, and we will need Expo Developer Account, which is this one, right? So you just have to search for Expo or https.expo.dev/account, then you can sign up if you don't have one. If you already have one, you can log in. Okay, so currently I don't have any project here. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back to my terminal. Okay, I'm going to navigate to my mobile repo, and then here I'm just going to say ESInit, which basically stands for initialize. Okay, so this is actually going to run, ask us a couple of questions, and once we are done, it's going to generate our project ID for us. So I'm going to use my personal account. Okay, it's asking whether the name should be mobile. Yeah, you can change the name, but I just prefer to use the mobile. Okay, so once we are done, when you go back to your app.json, now you could see we have some project ID information here, right? And then we have the owner here. Now when you go back to our developer account, let's try and refresh. Good, you could see the application is here, right? So it means now we can actually use the project ID right here. Okay, so now once we run the application, what is going to happen is the register function, right, is going to use this project ID to kind of create the token for us. So now I'm just going to, I think the Metro Bundler is ready, so I'm going to use my physical device to scan the QR code, and then from there we can proceed. Great, so you can see on my physical device that app is up and running, right? Now let's go down here. So at the bottom you could see we actually log in the token, right? So let me bring this one down a little bit. Yeah, so here we are console logging the token, and here is the token. Okay, so we can actually copy this token and then now use the token to send notification. Okay, so I'm just going to go back to I've opened Postman, right, just to test it. And when you check the server side, let me do a cross check here. Okay, and let me check. Okay, the app is running, so I can just, this is the base URL, so I can copy the base URL, come here, and then create a new request for that. Okay, so it's a post, so I'm going to say post, and then let's check the URL, api://push-notification. So I'm just going to come here and replace. Good, so now we have that. Let's create our body. So it takes in these fields, right? So I'm just going to copy these fields, go back to our Postman, then good. So now we can feed in the information. So here I'm just going to say test, and then here I'm going to say we are doing some testing. Okay, good. And then here the metadata can contain anything, right? It could be an object or whatever. And then let's go back to our mobile app and then copy this token. Okay, so you could clearly see it has some format, right? So it starts with exponent push token, right? And then bracket comes, and then we have the token inside, right? So that is the format of expo notification tokens, right? So I'm just going to paste that right here, and then now that we are done, we can actually make a request now. Let me position my mobile device at this end so that we can actually test it and then get eyes on our physical device as well. So I'm just going to make a request. Hopefully we don't face any issues or errors. Great. So I actually put my phone on down the steps so you couldn't see the pop-up, right? Now you could see that, oops. So the body says we not. Yeah, so you could see, I mean, the notification is in here, right? So the title is test, and then we are doing some testing, right? So basically that is what happens when I close. Okay, let me try and remove that on the step. Hopefully nobody calls me at this section. So let me make another request. Great. I don't know if you could hear the sound as well. Now we are getting the pop-up and you could see the message clearly, right? So basically this is how you can implement your expo notification. All right, so I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you did, kindly click on the subscribe button, like this video, share the video with friends, and see you in the next one. But before you go, I would want to plead with you. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, kindly do so by subscribing so that you can get some amazing content from us. If you already done that, what I would want you to do is let me know your thoughts about this video in the comment section. And if you want me to do or cover any content for you, can leave that in the comment section as well, and I will get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you very much. See you next time.